You had a really interesting conversation with Michael Caputo. He's the Health and Human Services spokesperson. He kind of made a number of statements on Facebook that got a lot of people's attention. He accused some government scientists of working against President Trump. You spoke to him about these accusations. He also mentioned something about his mental health, dealing with the coronavirus and the pandemic. What did you learn from that conversation? You spoke to him for like 45 minutes.
Yes, and so I think what's important to note first is that this is the spokesperson who is in charge of the messaging from the Department of Health and Human Services, which of course is taking the lead in trying to battle COVID-19. And Caputo stood by his assertion that there are scientists working against the administration, working against President Trump, who want to wait until after the election to really, you know, do anything productive because their main goal is to take down the president. So that is a conspiracy theory that he says is not exclusive to HHS, but is in other departments as well. The more concerning piece of this, though, is the fact that he admitted during this Facebook live chat with all of his friends and followers, he said that his mental health had failed him. And so that matters, because if he's acknowledging that and he's still doing the job, you know, still in the same role that he's assigned to, you have to wonder how that's impacting the work that he's doing. He actually said that his mental health is strong, but told me it is challenged because of everything he's going through. He claims that his family has been harassed and threatened multiple times. He says that there is a lot of pressure that comes along with dealing with the grave subject matters linked to the coronavirus, and admitted that that's really wearing down on him as well. You know, skeptics, though, and critics say that's not an excuse, and that he made several other pretty wild remarks during this venting session on Facebook, and that he should not be allowed to maintain his role, which is critical in getting the American public the information they need to make decisions about their daily lives.
Yeah, and Weijia, as you know, he previously deleted a series of tweets and social media posts in which he attacked Chinese people. And so he has a history of doing this. He's been a fiery supporter of the president on television for quite some time.